In this and the next lecture, I will integrate a graph with an image. To start, let's import the sketch I have for the end result. I go to File, Import, and open the sketch. I hold Shift plus Control, and make the sketch a bit smaller. I call the image, Sketch, and lock it. I set the opacity to 25%, and the blend mode to Multiply. I create a new layer, and call it, Legs. Now I import the image of the soccer player. I call the image, Bicycle Kick. I will increase the size of the image, until it roughly fits the sketch outline. As we see with the end result, I need the legs to be cut out. Normally you don't need the high precision, like the letter we traced in the last lecture. The node tool in Inkscape, lets you trace an image extremely fast. And the node tool, offers many possibilities, to customize the result when needed. I will hide the sketch. Before we can utilize the node tool, I will first place some nodes around the legs using the pen tool. I will place points, by roughly following the shape of the legs. As we see, I do not make any curves. I just place a point, when there is a change in direction. I don't worry about curves. The node tool is much faster at creating curves. With the football, I only click on the outer edges, as we saw in the last lecture. So I only click at the bottom, the left, and the top of the ball. Where there is some more important detail, I will zoom in a bit, and place some points. What is chopped off by the straight lines, will be corrected by the node tool. So I click there, where there are changes in the direction of the curve. Also for the bottom of the shoe, I click, pretending my lines are curved, even though they are not. Even the sharp points of the soccer shoe studs, will be taken care of by the node tool. When I have reached the shorts again, I can close the path. To do this, I click again on the first point. Now I select the node tool. I will select some nodes that I don't need, by dragging over them. Then I press delete. Now I will match the curves, by simply dragging the lines. I wouldn't do this to trace letters, but it works extremely fast. I have traced many images in GIMP and Photoshop in the past. But the node tool of Inkscape, is probably my favorite tool to trace images. This way of working, doesn't give the 100% accuracy, that for example is needed when you create a logo. But for tracing bitmap images, in my opinion, this isn't needed to get good results. As we see, I have full control over the curve. I drag a line, and can give it any curvature I want. And if I want to add a point, I simply double-click on a line. So now let's look at some extra features, that the node tool provides. I drew the spikes of the bottom shoe with a single node. If I find this a bit too pointy, I can easily make them more round. I select the spikes by shift-clicking on them. Then I click, on the Make Selected Node Smooth icon. Now let's have a look at the other foot. I will drag over the top nodes, and smooth them. It does give me the result I need, but you can do more. As we see, with a smooth node, the arms are linked. But let's say, I want to move the arms independently. To do this, click once on the Make Selected Nodes corner icon. We see the node changed from a square, to a diamond. The arms are not connected anymore. And if you want to remove the arms, click on the Make Selected Nodes corner icon, a second time. I will make the node smooth again. If you want the arms of a node, to have the same length at all times, click on Make Selected Nodes Symmetric. If I drag an arm, I see the other arm is mirrored, in the node. Auto Smooth, gives special kind of arms, that adjust themselves, when you drag the node. I will go back to a smooth node, where the arms are linked, but can have their own length. If you want to create a straight line between two curved nodes, select the nodes. Then click on Straighten Lines. Now the path between the nodes is straight, and the nodes are locked in their direction. This locking is to prevent the straight line to curve, when you adjust the handles. And to go back to a curve, simply drag the line. If you want to give an arm a different direction, but you don't want to change the length of an arm, hold the Alt key. And to add a point, simply double-click on a line. As we see, there are many ways to manipulate a curve with the node tool. If you don't want to see the arms, deselect the Show Bezier Handles icon. And to hide the path itself, deselect the Show Path Outline icon. I will delete some nodes. To quickly add nodes, without having to double-click many times, select two nodes. Then click, on Insert New Nodes, into selected segments. Each time you click, the amount of added nodes will double. Now my path is ready. Let's use the path, to cut out the legs. I call the path, Legs. I right-click on the path, and choose, Set Clip Group. I drag the image on the Clip Group folder. I want my image to be duotone, so I will add a blue rectangle. I click on a blue. I call the rectangle blue. I set blue to the color blend mode. I click on fill and stroke. I can now give the duotone the correct color. I drag the blue a bit more to cyan. In the next lecture, we will place the bars in the text.